Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. I think it's very important because occiput dysfunctions are more common. As a physiotherapist, we daily practice, we see this type of dysfunction, but the terms which you are using for giving the techniques and some techniques are very new because we are not able to understand the proper dysfunction of the patient. They say that they have a pain in this hair, there, sometimes lying down position. So that today you were explaining that occiput and the upper cervical dysfunction, they are the correlated with each other because of the facet joint of atlas and axis, the movement of facet joint where one side is the space is very less, so lateral flexion comes. So these things we know, but how to deal with this type of dysfunction is very important. So which you are showing according to the atlanto-occipital technique, which you are showing. The cranial sacral release, we know that how we can give the hand movement that it goes inside the, but the muscles as well as the ligament stability, I think we were missing it. We were not checking, basically we were not checking these type of dysfunction if there is an instability of the ligament of occiput region. And this is matched with the upper cervical, that extensors, which we were not checking properly. We are just checking for the musculars if there is a spasm or tightness in the lower cervical, but we normally we miss upper cervical and the occiput region. So I think it's very important to understand the which type of technique with the right hand placement is, I think, very important, because if I am keeping my hand here and there, it means I am not giving any treatment to the patient. I am just specifying that I am giving the treatment, but if my hand is not on
the most
the
important, commonly what we do is, in the beginning stages, we give too much of pressure.
Yeah.
To right. palpate. Okay. Right. So that should be kept in control and see that just to do a proper contact, you should feel the space. Okay. The articular space.
Mm. Right. So I think the hand move placement, because of that, you were showing in all the angles that will be easy for us. So we can see the your movement, where is your thumb is going, where is the fingers placement in the base of occiput or the atlas, we are blocking the atlas or occiput axis. So I think these things are very important to learn according to the cranial osteomanual therapy, because these are very small points. If we miss it, so our treatment will be fail, and we will I think move through in a wrong direction. So because this is a very,
no, the slides will also give you a more clearer perspective. Okay, because the picture is there, hand placement is there, so you know that.
Yes, sir.
This is more of the direct clinical approach what you're actually seeing. When I show the PPT, it will complement, and afterwards again you might have to do two times. You have to watch the slide, then do it. So it might be parallel like that, but you'll realize now that atlanto-occipital, so first and foremost is the soft tissue screening. So spasm tightness screening or the ligament instability screening. So these things. And the next thing comes to bilateral versus unilateral.
Yes.
So next is optionally if extremity or the respiration or the other differentiation, the functional muscle activity, whether it is needed. And then the next one comes to unilateral versus bilateral techniques. Right. So in bilateral techniques, which are the techniques which we can do? Okay. So condylar decompression, so we are giving a distraction, so like that. Or unilateral technique, which is indirect technique through the frontal bone, diagonally you are giving the pressure. So ultimately the mechanical thing is occiput going posterior and atlas translated anterior. Okay, so this is the major therapeutic one which we are trying to achieve.
Occiput coming posterior, okay, atlas is going anterior. And this was very nice, that the distraction, that how you were giving with the contralateral side of the frontal bone, we were using this technique also. And articular techniques are, I think, very important, which we were not more aware of these type of technique. Myofascial, we know that. And today, which I have learned very new thing about the ligament stability for the occiput region. That is very interesting that and you have shown about that both the ligaments, which are related to axis. That is, and the articular techniques are also, I think, very important to learn for treating this occiput dysfunction.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That occipito-adlanto release, that is very important.
Yeah. So now we move on with the further demonstration.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir.
See that. When you are actually looking at the occiput, you can see that the foramen magnum is not accessible in the palm. Okay? You can't go that much deep. You have the condyles, which are articulating with the atlas. Okay? The two facets. Okay? Beside the foramen magnum. But when you are keeping the fingers, your finger will come in the squamous portion of the occiput.
Right.
This is the prominence.
Yeah.
Okay. So that is where you will come maximally. And then little bit it will go here. So this is what you can get access to the occiput. This much only, half of the occiput. Okay. So remember that during the releases, the finger from this area, the bend which is there. So from here, you're going to the deeper region. So here muscles are relaxing. So you're going deeper. Okay. And you are reaching the atlas here. Okay. So this is the facet. Okay. This is the facet. So atlas is here. So your finger reaches here. Okay. So from here to here. So this is hardly 3 to 4 millimeters. Okay. Which you can actually go inside. When you are evaluating the what is called as